The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they got together, and to disconcert him, one of them put a question, "Master, which is the greatest commandment of the law?" Jesus said, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second resembles it. You must love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang the whole law and the prophets also." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters, you have studied already in the time of our First Communion Catechism about the Ten Commandments. At the end, we always say all these first commandments can be summarized into two commandments: loving God above everything and everyone, and also loving one another as we love ourselves. This is the summary of our whole Christian teaching, Catholic teaching, we can say. And today, Jesus reminds us of it through this liturgy of the word once again. A little girl is asked by the priest, "Do you love me?" Immediately the girl responds, the LKG girl responds, "Father, first tell me, do you love me? Then I will tell you." Little children are so spontaneous in responding to some of our questions. We read in the first letter of Saint John the same thing. Not that we loved God first, but God the Father loved us first, and especially by sending His Son and make Him die for our sins, He has manifested His love for us. I always say, why should we love God? Our love for God is only our response of gratitude. You know, on one of the evening prayers, we have this beautiful psalm, "O give thanks to the Lord, for His good, His great love is without end, His mercy endures forever." So we have heard that psalm, prayed that psalm so frequently. I think each one of us has to sing that psalm, our own psalm, right from the time we were conceived in our mother's womb. "Lord, thank you for giving me such wonderful parents, wonderful brothers and sisters. Thank you for the school where I had my initial education. Thank you for bringing me to this congregation. Thank you for your love and protection up to this day." We have to go on singing that song. I think today Sister Manjula also sings her own song of thanksgiving for all that had been in the past. There might have been problems. There might have been situations that were not so pleasing. But then the guiding hand of the Lord has always been there up to this day. Thank you, Lord. If you and I are alive here in this place of grace this morning, it is only because of the abundant mercy and special love of God for us. That we should not forget. So when Jesus says the first commandment, as it is reported in Deuteronomy, "Shema Israel, listen, O Israel," what you have to do? You have to love your God with all your strength, all your soul, all your heart, all your mind. What does it mean? The Lord has given us everything. He has loved us in that way. God the Father in creating us, the Son in dying for us. They did not calculate in loving us. So our response to the love of God is our gratitude, grateful love. And then we are called to give the Lord wholeheartedly. I always say, when can we, our moments of prayer is a manifestation of the love of God. Okay, but then what do? We are sitting at the Lord's feet like Mary of Bethany in order to become a meaningful Martha. That is our whole life. We thank the Lord. We praise the Lord. We realize more and more the love of God for us. Then you are able to go out and then do your work. Be it study, be it teaching, or healing the patients, whatever it may be. This is our whole occasion. If you read the first letter of St. Paul to the Romans, we know the first 11 chapters are about love of God for us. St. Paul says, God's love is poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. And in the 8th chapter, for example, who can separate us from the love of Christ? So after saying all this, the second part, as Jesus says, the second part of the commandment, love one another as you love yourself. That is the second part. Then we have enormous strength and energy to love one another. This is the message, I think, today, once again, that is given to us. Loving God. Loving God without keeping anything for ourselves. Our time, our energy, our vitality. Though it is not repeated, love your neighbor means there also. Sometimes we are so calculative. How much can I give to others? How much time can I spend for this? Will it affect my own personal welfare? And so on and so forth. Loving others as we love ourselves. Seems a little girl who was studying 6th standard brought a beautiful present to her teacher on her birthday. A shell, seashell. When the seashell, when you listen to it, as if the whole sea is speaking like that. Some kind of music comes from that shell. Then the teacher asked her, where did you get it? Because though we are on the seashore, our village, it is not found in our part of the seashore. She said, teacher, I found it 7 kilometers away. Then there was no bus facility to go to that particular place. The teacher knows it. Then, how did you go? I went walking only. I walked 7 kilometers and came back walking 7 kilometers. You need not have troubled so much for giving this present to me, the teacher said. Then the girl replied, teacher, even the walking is included in the gift, teacher. Even my walk up and down is included in that gift, teacher. That should be also our life. Sister Manjula's life, your life, my life. Our whole journey from the time of our birth should be included in the gift that we give to the Lord. We are called today. Jesus summarized all their commandments into two. God gave 10 commandments through Moses, 10 commandments. So in the course of the years, the Jewish people, especially those experts in law, multiplied these commandments 365 days. So 365 negative commandments. Don't do this, don't do this, don't. It seems there are 248 bones or something. So 248 positive commandments. Altogether 613 commandments. Jesus summarized all these commands, 613 commandments, into two commandments. Love God, love one another. And Jesus, towards the end of his life, told us very clearly that if we love him, we have to follow his commandments. So loving God entails that we love one another. That is our whole occasion. And Jesus said, love like me. You know how much I love you. I washed the feet of the apostles. I gave my life. I was humble, gentle. I often say, sometimes people say, why do you want to become a sister? I want to serve the Lord. Service in itself is neutral. Service becomes a virtue only when there is humility and charity. So loving our brothers and sisters with humility and charity, this is the way that Jesus asks us to love. And in today's first reading, a beautiful passage, you know how bitter would have been the situation of Naomi. There was famine in the land of Judah. They went to Moab, a foreign land. First, she lost her husband. Then two sons she had, Mahlon and Chilion. Both of them married Moabite women, and both the sons also died. The three men in her life, all are lost. How bitter, what a terrible experience. The woman wants to go back to her country, but then the eldest daughter-in-law, Orpah, says, okay, goodbye. She also says, okay, you go to your people. But the younger daughter-in-law, Naomi, what beautiful words. This is the beautiful expression of our love for God, loyalty to our brothers and sisters. We can never forget. Do not press me to leave you and to turn back from your company. Sometimes some of the junior sisters, or even after perpetual profession, they want to go away because there are problems and the world looks more attractive. Why to live in this congregation at all? Some of them are thinking like that. Look at the words of Naomi. For wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you live, I will live. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. This verse alone is enough for our life. Lord, I have decided to follow you. Till the very end, I will be faithful. In moments of distress, I don't want to desert Naomi, the mother-in-law. That's what Ruth says. And the Lord blesses her. And through her, David is born later, and then the Messiah is born in the family. If you have such dedication like Ruth in choosing God and choosing our brothers and sisters to whom we are called to serve, it will be really wonderful. Today is also the 25th of August, the feast of St. Louis, a king at the age of already 12 years of age. He married and then had 11 children. But then, unlike other kings who are arrogant, worldly, who had no faith, this great king was very prayerful, doing charity, doing penance, meditating. It is said that he was also a friend of the great St. Thomas Aquinas. A life of simplicity he led, and sought God, sought the brothers and sisters. Very rarely kings can become saints. This Louis the Ninth of the 13th century is a great example. Whatever we have, everything is God's. Let us give back to the Lord. In this Eucharist, we bring something to the altar, the bread and wine. We get back somebody from the altar, that is Jesus. We offer bread and wine to the Father, and then the Holy Spirit transforms the bread and wine into the body and blood of Christ, signifying the total self-gift of Jesus. May we make our life a great gift. May we become blessings. Some people make us happy when they come, others make us happy when they go. May our presence be happy to others, not when we go away, by our thoughts, by our body language, by little deeds of kindness. May we become blessings, and may we fulfill the great commandment of the Lord. Love God, love one another. Amen.